Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You are watching South Asia Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 10th of May. India's top court grants interim bail to Delhi Chief Minister K. Jewal till June 1st, allowed to campaign for general elections. Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir observes shutter-down strike after police crackdown on protesters. And amid strained ties, India fully withdraws its soldiers from Maldives. And now for all the details. Nearly after 2 months, India's Supreme Court on Friday granted an interim bail to Delhi's Chief Minister, AAP convener Arvind Kejriwal till June 1st. The final phase of voting for the 7th stage 2024 Lok Sabha election. During this period, the minister will be allowed to campaign for Lok Sabha elections. However, the court also ruled that the Kejriwal would not be allowed to discharge any official duties as Chief Minister. Kejriwal was arrested in March in liquor excise policy case. The Enforcement Directorate alleged that the liquor policy, which is now scrapped, created by the AAP government, allowed it to receive kickbacks for license allotment, which was to the tune of 100 crore rupees that was used to fund poll campaigns. The AAP party and Kejriwal had firmly denied the charges and have accused the BJP of making false allegations to discredit the party and its leaders before the election. Delhi goes to the polls on May 25th.
Indicated that they are granting interim release / bail to Mr. Arvind Kejriwal, and that order of interim release will be operable up till 2nd of June, that is during the election process, and there is no restriction on his campaigning as to what he can say, what he cannot say while he is out in these 20-22 days.
India said on Thursday it would wait for Canadian authorities to share information on the 3 Indian men arrested and charged with the murder of Khalistani terrorist Hardeep Singh Nijjar. During the weekly media briefing, India's Foreign Ministry spokesperson Randhir Jaiswal acknowledged New Delhi's awareness of the arrests but stressed the lack of formal communication from Ottawa. He reiterated that Canadian authorities haven't shared any relevant evidence or information regarding Nijjar's killing. While the Canadian police arrested and charged 3 Indian men for the murder, but so far haven't established a link to the Indian government.
Teen Bharatiyon ko hirasat mein liya gaya hai Nijjar ke mamle mein. Hum logo ko bhi bataya gaya iske bare mein. Halanki iske bare mein koi formal औपचारिक रूप से कोई राजनयिक कम्युनिकेशन हमारे पास नहीं आया है. नो स्पेसिफिक और रेलेवेंट एविडेंस और इन्फॉर्मेशन हैज बीन शेयर्ड बाय द कैनेडियन अथॉरिटीज इन रिगार्ड टू दिस पर्टिकुलर मैटर टिल डेट विथ अस. यू विल देयरफॉर अंडरस्टैंड अ व्यू दैट द मैटर इज बीइंग प्रीजज्ड व्हेन पीपल से एक्स और वाई. ऑब्वियसली देयर आर पॉलिटिकल इंटरेस्ट एट वर्क.
Hardeep Singh Nijjar, designated terrorist in India, was shot dead outside a Gurudwara in June 2023. The Canadian Prime Minister cited credible allegations implementing the Indian government in the killing, sparking a diplomatic crisis between New Delhi and Ottawa. India denounced these accusations as the work of vested political interests and has blamed Ottawa for providing a haven for separatists and extremists in Canada. Almost after a month, 5 out of 17 Indian crew members were released after being seized by Iranian commandos in an Israeli-affiliated container ship. The Indian embassy in Iran, in a post on X, thanked the authorities and also confirmed that the 5 crew members had departed the country and would be making their way home soon. Though the work isn't over yet, as New Delhi has to still secure the release of 11 remaining Indian crew members. The release comes after India pressed into action to secure their release. Tensions had escalated between Iran and the West amid the ongoing war between Israel and Hamas. At least 7 labourers were killed by gunmen at Pakistan's Gwadar port at night while they were sleeping. The bodies were taken to Karachi on Thursday, The port is located in troubled southwestern Balochistan province, which borders Afghanistan and Iran. Nobody has taken the responsibility yet. Baloch separatist militants have in the past targeted laborers from eastern Punjab province, like the ones in the latest shooting. These separatists have long been fighting the government to demand a greater share in the mineral-rich province's natural resources. Gwadar is the site of several Beijing-backed projects under the $65 billion China-Pakistan Economic Corridor investment as part of the Belt and Road Initiative.
गवादर सुरबंदर के इलाके में ये वाकया हुआ था फायरिंग का, और 7 अफराद की जो है लाशें हैं ये, जिनकी गुसल कफन के हवाले से कराची ईदी सरदखाने में मुंतकिल किया हुआ है, और यहाँ से अब ईदी सरदखाने के ईदी मोर्चरी है मोबाइल मोर्चरी के ज़रिए पंजाब के इलाके खानेवाल में इनके आबाई गांव फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट बाकुम फैसल ईदी साहब की तरफ से रवाना किया जा रहा है।
आफ्टर अ मैसिव पुलिस क्रैकडाउन ऑन प्रोटेस्टर्स, पाकिस्तान ऑक्यूपाइड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर ऑन फ्राइडे witnesses a shutter down strike against the police action. Arpot.
A day after a massive police crackdown on protesters, a shutter down strike was observed on Friday in Pakistan occupied Jammu and Kashmir. The strike was called by the Jammu and Kashmir Joint Awami Action Committee in response to police actions that detained several activists and baton charged protesters in a bid to prevent the long march against the government. The group has been protesting unjust taxation, uncontrolled inflation, and severe shortages of essentials like flour. The protesters have also raised concerns over hefty electricity bills and have demanded ownership of local land and water resources, which they say are being used in hydroelectric power projects for Pakistan.
फ्री बिजली दो जो हमारे हिस्से में बनती है, हमें हम चाहते हैं कि ये जंगलों के वारिस हमारे बच्चे के लाए, इन दरियाओं के वारिस हमारे बच्चे के लाए, और उसका नतीजा क्या मिलता है? जब हम 11 मई की पुरमन काल, पिछला पूरा साल हो गया है लोगों, हमें हड़तालें करते हुए, हमें रैलियां निकालते हुए, एक पत्ता तक नहीं टूटा।
Activists accuse Pakistan of falsely claiming to have granted autonomy to POJK, where elected officials have no say in policy making. Several political activists have been voicing their concerns on the international platform, as they say assertive international intervention is the only way the helpless people can be saved from imminent doom.
Moving on, a day after India-Maldives meet, New Delhi on Friday completed the withdrawal of its soldiers from Mali just ahead the deadline set by island nation's president Mohammad Muizu. Repatriation of about 89 Indian military personnel stationed in the Maldives to operate and maintain 2 helicopters and Dornier aircraft that India had gifted earlier was a key pledge of Muizu during his presidential campaign in 2023. The development comes a day after India's External Affairs Minister met his Maldives counterpart, Musa Zamir, where two leaders had extensive talks on bilateral ties and regional security issues of both the countries. The Maldives is India's key maritime neighbour in the Indian Ocean region and occupies a special place in its initiatives like Sagar and the Neighbourhood First policy of the Modi government. Sri Lanka's Election Commission announced on Thursday that it would hold the presidential election due this year between September 17 and October 16. In a statement, the poll body said it will call for the nominations to hold the presidential election within the specified time frame in terms of the provisions of the constitution by virtue of powers vested to the commission. The election will commence by September 2024, the statement said. However, several lawmakers, including those from the ruling faction, have expressed displeasure over the announcement and have called for parliamentary elections prior to the presidential polls, as reported by the Daily Mirror. Opposition lawmakers argue that holding the general election before the presidential polls will attract a larger voter base. While the election for Sri Lanka's top office is due this year, the parliamentary election is scheduled for 2025. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.